We are going to discuss about different type of air refrigeration system and how we are achieving the refrigeration by using air, and this is usually done in aircraft systems. So first one is simple air cooling system. First we can look into the procedure and the processes involved in it, and there are some differences are introduced to this simple air cooling system to achieve different other systems. First one, simple air cooling system. Here what happens is, so this is the aircraft, and wing, under the wing there is a main compressor, and air will be blowing into this compressor. That part is this one. So ambient air is entering into compressor, and this is the main compressor inside this tunnel, and this is the main compressor. So from that main compressor, a portion will be fed for combustion, and a portion we are extracting it for refrigeration purpose. And first, when ambient air enters this particular tunnel, here there is a shocking effect, and the ramming occurs there, and because of that ramming there will be an increase in pressure, and this one enters the main compressor, where this air is again compressed, and this compressed air, when air is compressed automatically, so if we are drawing the TS diagram, it is like this. First, let this be the ambient condition. So in ambient condition there will be a pressure and temperature. So first it is ramming. Under ramming, if we are considering only ideal processes, under ramming, so it is, there is an increase in pressure. So this is the ram pressure. After that there is a main compression. This is the compression in the compressor. So in compressor, this is the compressor pressure. So after compressor, this compressed air is passed through heat exchanger. So in the heat exchanger, this heat exchanger, there is no compression at all. But in heat exchanger, the heat of this air is exchanged with a portion blood from this rammed air. So a portion blood from this rammed air take away heat from this compressed air, such that the temperature reduces but pressure remains constant. So it is a constant pressure process here. There is a decrease in temperature. So after that, this air is passed through a expander. So in expander, it undergo expansion and it reaches the pressure, cabin pressure, and then it is applied to cabin at a cabin temperature. This is what happens in simple air cooling system. And here, as this is an expander, this is a turbine. So when air expands, we will get a work output, and this work output is used to run a fan. That fan is used to drive the ambient air so that the cooling is achieved in heat exchanger. Now in bootstrap air cooling system, this the same thing, but what they are doing is, after this first heat exchanger, this is the first heat exchanger, after this first heat exchanger they will use a second compressor so that the air is once again compressed. So after, then it is again fed to another heat exchanger, so that again the temperature is reduced, and then it will be fed to expander. So here we are only using a single compressor. That means compression is achieved only once, but here we are using two compressors, such that the pressure, we are able to compress it more compression can be achieved. So if we are able to compress it more, here when it comes to expander, the expansion can be achieved in a great extent, so that the temperature reduction can be more, so cooling effect can be increased. So that's a bootstrap air cooling system. So in reduced ambient air cooling, reduced ambient air cooling means, here when the air enters, a ramming effect occurs, and the air present here will be rammed air. So in the first system, we have already seen this rammed air is applied to heat exchanger. So here, if the ambient air is at a temperature say minus 10 degree, after ramming, the pressure minus 10 degree and say 0.1 bar, after ramming the pressure will be increasing to say 0.2 bar, and say the temperature is somewhat about 10 degree Celsius. That is, after ramming, pressure and the temperature increases. So this air at 0.2 bar and 10 degree is supplied to heat exchanger. But here what they do is, this rammed air is again passed through a turbine, such that a cooling effect is obtained, because in turbine expansion of this ram layer takes place, so that this ram layer at 0.2 bar and 10 degree is again reduced to ambient condition in this turbine. So that after this one, the ram condition is already set at this point 10 degree, minus 10 degree and 0.1 bar. So after expansion, it reaches minus 10 degree and 0.1 bar. So again, then it is fed to heat exchanger. So that is the difference between simple air cooling system and a reduced ambient air cooling system. Here we are using a turbine such that the ram air is reduced to ambient system by using an expander. Now if you are using regenerated air cooling system, here again as in the similar case, first it is passed through a heat exchanger, then we are using a second heat exchanger. In second heat exchanger, so after passing through the second heat exchanger, it will be passing through a turbine, and after turbine air will be sent to cabin. But here a portion of this air that is fed to cabin is taken back and is used to exchange heat from the air in the first second heat exchanger. So here we are using two heat exchangers, of which the second exchanger, heat exchanger, is supplied by cold air from turbine, the last turbine or expander. So this is the difference between regenerative air cooling. So as we are taking, if m1 mass is the total mass coming, m is the total mass coming out, m1 will be given to this one and m2 will be taken back. So this is why we call it as regenerative air cooling system. So in simple air cooling system, we are making some adequate differences such that we are able to obtain other three type of cooling systems, and these all are used in aircraft engines, aircraft systems. Thank you.